Hello everyone, welcome to Art Thrill Studio, and today we are going to do a full idol of Ganesha and a very warm welcome to all of you and my hearty wishes for a happy Raksha Bandhan to all brothers and sisters out there. Okay, so if you can see and view my video very well, you can just type a yes so that we can start. Hi Lata, hi Varsha, Jyoti, Harshita, welcome. So today what we are going to do is, we are going to make the full idol, how to do it in a Kalamkari style. Yes, those who missed the session yesterday, they can view it. It is still post. It is on YouTube, and that will tell you how, what is the difference between the faces and what are the main criteria for doing the Kalamkari. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Okay, so I got a yes, and then we will start. And for that, I'm just taking a pencil to just sketch the whole figure first, because when we make the body figure, the whole body and ornaments and the overlapping of the hands and limbs will happen. So it is always very important for us to chop out the first structure or the basic form of the body, and then later on we can just finalize our picture with ink. Thank you so much. Thank you. You all are welcome here. And let me put it on my camera. I'll fix the camera and there we'll start. So what I've taken here is an A4 size paper. A4 size paper, and we will be doing a full idol. Full idol here. Now, when we make any idol or any figure, it is very important for us to figure out the proportions. So here, I will be roughly dividing into 5 equal parts. So I'm just giving a little idea so that while you are practicing it with me, you will get the idea of the proportions. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, leaving a little top and the bottom, very less top and the bottom, so that I can just form the picture over here. So roughly how do we chalk it is, first place is for the mukut, the second is for the face, the third is for the upper half of the body, the second is for the tummy, and the last is the lower part of the body. So this is how we are going to draw the Ganesha. I will be drawing it with pencil, just chalking few lines, and then we will figure out with the pen. So here, I will just give a very basic shape. So I will just give a shape like this so that I get to know that here it is the mukut. Then I'll just go a little dark so that it's easier for you all to see. Not very dark, because I won't be tracing these lines anyway. So the width of the face, since it is the elephant face, we are going to make the whole body and the face a little broad as compared to the other forms. And here the ear, very roughly, just chop it very roughly, see to it that both the sides are symmetrical. Now here, I will be doing the upper part of the body, as in the shoulder. So, this is the shoulder. And now, since it will have a trunk here, so I'll just make a trunk. Initially, it will be broad, just the same size as this, and slowly it will go a little thin. So giving it a very, see to it that it doesn't go very thin. So just a rough sketch over here. Now, this is the arm. The upper part of the body ends up here, and then the tummy will be starting. So, I am taking the belly as the big span of ears. With that, I will be taking, and it will be like so. So this is the head, upper part of the body. So upper part of the body, we're just going to make the chest and this. All the ornamentation we will be doing after our thing is chopped out. This will be the hand. Hands will also be thick. And we have done it in our mudras. I'm not doing any mudra. I'm just making a place as a circle for the hand. We will figure out when we'll do the final. We'll directly do it. Here also, the hand. Now, what is the importance of doing the body structure first is that when the hand comes, we might not be doing the outlines, but then we will just know where our hand is and how much of it is hidden, so we can space it out. So again, I'm just making a circle, rough circle for the hand here. So if I hold it closer, you will be able to see how rough it is. Just making those circles to chalk out where the things will just fall. So this is how you space your picture, how you plan your picture. Now this is the foot. Sorry, the leg. And this will be one leg over here, and then the other one, this side. So this, I have done it very lightly. I will thereafter, I will be starting it with a pen, so it's clear then. So I'm just making the cloth. So these will all be covered, and how we do the further decoration of the picture. So I'll just place it a little up so that you get the full view of it, and then we will start. To begin the picture, I would prefer giving it a mandap, but before giving a mandap, I chopped my whole picture here so that I know how big it is coming. Now, these are two limbs. I would extend one more limb on this side. And one more on this other side. So the angles of these two limbs will be similar. And here is the hand. We have already done the mudra, so I will just go finally on it in one go. I'm just plotting it. So I get to know where is the shastras and the shank and everything is coming. Once you plot this, then you will have the idea of how big the curve here and how much space for your mandap is left. Good afternoon. I'm very good. Thank you. Welcome everyone. So from here we will start the mandap. Now it is very important for all of us, probably it's coming straight for me. If in case you are drawing, always take the center of your thing and make a line. As we did in our previous class, yesterday's class, that all the things should come aligned. The tip of the crown, the center of the tika, the navel, and they all should be in full alignment if we are making a straight figure. If in case it is turned, definitely the waist will have its own movement or the head will be tilted. So that will happen. But right now, are just doing the straight one and not much I'm doing on this. It's all freehand here. If you feel, you may use your scales to check. I will also put it here. So if in case you're making a mandap, you just align it that, okay, it's falling in the straight line. So if the mandap is here, then just go ahead and plan it here. That's it. We do not do much of the measurements, but just plan. So this is my mandap roughly. I will just make the detailing. What the pen I am using is a waterproof pen, and I advise all the time to use a waterproof pen, as painting or not painting is another option. So just leave the scope. If you want to paint, you can always be on the safer side. So one is a little thin, close, and now I'm giving it a little broad outline. Now these structures may vary, whatever type of mandap you want to give. Make it. So I'm just giving it a half mandap, not the full pillar. If you want to give the pillar, you may try to give that as well. So it is just half in because my figure will be quite broad. Now this totally depends on your own wish. This can be a different design for you altogether. My personal take on any of the picture is that I do a left and right together. So I just keep balancing the whole thing so that it doesn't go out of proportion. So you'll see I'll be doing one side and then the other. I won't be spending much time on the mandap because then our main focus is on the Kalamkari figure. So I'll start with this. The top of the head. The side of the face. So this I've already plotted actually roughly, and now I'm very confident on putting the pictures. Putting the lines. So this can be your take as well. Now I'll go on the top of the crown. There can be various designs for this. multiple bands. Now I'm giving a variation here, which is a little more curvier. Yesterday, somebody asked me if we can give variation, so I was just doing a different way of doing the crown. It totally depends on your wish, so do not feel that this is not done or it's not. It's just that these circles are very important. Even if the face is turned sideways, you will get to see these. So I'm giving those curves, and this finishes with the thing. To get the whole idea of the face, it's very important for us to do the hair and the ear both. So here. I'm just doing a little curved curls. So here, doing a double outline to segregate it from the outer design. Just going for the decoration. Now we'll slowly complete each feature we are completing, followed by the detailing. Here I would wish to put the tassels that is always there for the gods. So this way. Now this is the face part, and now I'm going for the trunk. The trunk would include the ivory as well, and you may twist the trunk whichever way you want. There are some mythical beliefs as left or right. I'm not very sure about it. So if you want to put it in your puja, if at all, then you might be, those who are very specific can do it the way they want to. So this is the trunk here. Then one tusk will be full and the one was broken, it broke, so we are just making the half of that. So this, now we can go ahead and do the decoration on the face as well. I would, just to see how we have to figure out the face, when the face is there, we divide it into two equal parts, and this is the place where the eye will be. If we place the eye too high on the forehead, then it gives a very tensed look. So we'll keep it relaxed. So if this is the place for the face, divide it into half. And this is the place where your eyes will fall. You can always make a T in the middle so that you know where it is flowing like this. So this will give you one idea and it will be easy for you to plot the teacup. I'll do it with the pencil first. So I'm making the eyes. Now, this is not a straight eye. You will see that it is going in a 45 degree angle. I've made it with the pencil and I'm not quite happy with it, and now I will be start to ink it. The eyes are the most important feature of any face, and so just be very, very careful while you do it. The things that you have to be careful is that left and right should be equal. So balance it well. And then start to give it the final look. Now leaving one dot in the middle of the eye, which as a shine spot gives a very lively look to the eye. Instead, in place of like doing the full thing, just leave one shiny part. Now the eyebrow and the eyes, and now the eyelids. So this is giving me the full eye look. I'd just rather keep a little, this dot a little smaller like that. Now I get the center line. I will be placing the teacup. Now, whichever type of tikka you need to put, you can put that. Some people put it flat, some in the moon shape, whatever is your wish, you can add that kind of a tikka. I will be adding it. like this. Now following the center of the trunk, whichever way the trunk is going, I will be shifting my design the same way to give it a little twist. So this is the face that's ready. If you are liking the video, just I request you to put a like so that I get to know how many people are there and liking. So this is the first or the only the face. Many of the pictures we will see. If in case it's Kalamkari, not full idol is done, only this much is done, and people just make this as a motif. But what if we have to make the full? Now we will go ahead with. So for those who joined late, we divided it into 5 equal parts. So one part was this, and the other part is this. And now the third part, the same proportions will show us the upper part of the body. So for upper part of the body, giving nice curvy shoulders like this. The decoration over here. Now here, since in this part I have already planned to do a hand over here, so I will draw the hand, and then because the body will be covered behind, so just doing the hand. We've already done this specific mudra, was done in the day 2, so, and all the other mudras as well, so I'm not repeating the formation, just making the bangles. So the thumb. Now this hand spec for the specific Ganesha, the hand will be very very fleshy, very and here's the little finger. This further going on to the and this kind of a hand where he is holding his broken tooth. This way. Now we get to see that this portion is hidden over here, and now we will come and we'll complete the whole picture. We'll have the arm decoration as well here. Now going on to the next one. This hand is going down. So first we will make the hand so that we get to know how much of it we do not have to make, because all these things, the trunk, the hand, the other hand, is coming over the body, and probably all the garlands and everything will be hidden. So it's very important not to start it from one side, see what is coming over. So now check the thickness of the first hand and then only move on to the other. Like this. I will be making the hand facing down. Like this. Well, this is the thumb. This mudra also, we have done these, all the mudras that I am doing today have been extensively discussed in a previous class of day 2, where we did only the mudras. So this is one hand where he is holding a modak. So for doing the modak, we just do this small dots. And we finish this. This gives the other hand. So these are the two limbs that are coming forward, and we will do the bangles. Follow the same design as you did for the first one. And this is one limb here. I will follow this. I have to do the same chest on this side. And this is giving the curve. We'll do the same on this side of the limb. Now we'll continue and do the decoration on the body part. Tell the pen you're using. It's a waterproof pen. You get many waterproof pens. Here what I'm using is a Uniball Eye waterproof pen. You also get different waterproof pen with different thickness. So this is like a snowman drawing pen. So all these drawing pens will have waterproof ink. So you can take a waterproof ink and then you're good to go with that. If in case you do not have a Uniball Eye, you may use any of the waterproof pen. So, but there are few gel pens, they say that they are waterproof, wherein they are not. So I would advise you to always do a test first and then put it on the drawing. So now with this, I will be doing the upper limbs. Bangles. And now here the finger. This is the thumb. And here two down fingers like this. Like this. So this is one form of the hand. We will be doing the very same form here. Doing a little bit of detailing, adding the rings, and here I will be adding the all the weapon just So this is one that he's holding. Slowly you will see that it looks very complex, but once we go section by section and then do it, it's not that difficult. Here, and now for the shoulder, there's one more thing that we do this cover. This is mostly seen in the Kalamkari style of painting, the covers here. Now we'll do the same on this side. Just check that the limb is starting from which, and it should be starting from where now. So the same angle, the same thickness. That will help you just to figure out that it is coming in symmetry. Now this side I'm doing. How would we determine that somebody in my second day video had asked, how do we determine whether the left in between the left hand and the right hand? So the best way to determine which is which hand is, first you will see where the thumb is. So if the thumb is, thumb will tell you whether it is a left hand or a right hand, but it is still deceptive. Why deceptive? Because if I happen to turn the back of my hand, my thumb is here on the other side. Whereas if I flip it on this side, it is on that side. So the first thing is you have to check for the thumb. The second thing, you have to check for the palm, whether the palm is facing you or whether the back side of the hand or the nails are facing you. So these two things will tell you, even if the picture is not seen, if you see the hand, you will be able to tell you tell whether it's the left or a right hand. So that is one very important thing that I thought of picking it up when I will be doing some idle. So you know, on this day two, there was a question and I thought of clearing it today. I really don't know who mentioned that actually. So now this time here, these finger. So like this. Now here again, I'm giving the If you have any doubts or any queries, you can put it up across and then I'll try to answer all of them while we are working on this picture. Anybody has any doubts, you can write it now. So here we are doing it on this side. We have to again do it on the other side. Our Indian gods and goddesses are really, they have a lot of jewels around. They are so dressed up. You can go endlessly in creating those details. These small dots give a very beautiful edge to it when you will be coloring. If in case you want to color, you can see the difference how with one dot it creates a different effect. So probably with the festival around, you can just make one Kalamkari Ganesha and put it on your in your puja on Diwali. So this, now this part is done. I have to do the lower portion here, the garland and the other stuff. So here now I will follow the same, but I have to give way to all the things that are overlapping. Thank you, Sujata. Thank you. Okay. So after this, now we will see, as I told, whether for this, the same proportion here, the second compartment, the third compartment, we are done with the third compartment. And now with the same proportions, we make one more section and that will do, that will be the belly of the Ganesha. So here, just giving it one curve. Now it depends on how broad you want the picture to be. We cannot make it like too broad, but just the face plus the ear, that span will determine the lower part of the body. That will still look proportionate. So here, now connect it. Remember to connect this part. This is hidden over here. So I'll not connect this part because I have to make the legs here. So this part is done. I'm not creating the lower cloth as well because the main feature of the body has to be created first. Every time, whenever you make any picture, think of the body being created first. Later, the clothes, the jewelry will come later. So here, and now I'll just go a little more and elaborate the design because we don't want to leave it. And here on the Now this on the other side, it is hidden, so don't worry about that as well. We just go around like this. Giving the full extension of this till the end. Now the next part I made here, so if it is in a sitting posture, one leg is up and the other is flattened down. I'm giving it a small knee effect like that. I might not go on the double outline here. One leg I've made here. How to go about the foot? When we make the foot, it goes like in a wedge shape. So roughly, if I tell you, I just made this kind of a shape here. That is telling me where the foot is. But now I will go ahead and do the detailing on that. So, one toe. Then one, two, three, and four. So this way. Now here comes the curves, because we have to imagine which way we are looking at it, and then the knee like that. So the look is from the top in the front, so it will appear to be like this. Now here I'll create more design. This is one foot. Now giving the knee in this side like this, very simple, but this line form will give you a little effect on the foot. Yeah. And I will go ahead and do the other side of the foot as well. So the bulge and the thickness of the one foot has to be the same on the other. So, nice rounded one, and then the toe. See to it that the toes are in a similar form. Give some space between the foot and the toe. So if you have not subscribed the channel, do subscribe and support the channel. Artful Studio keeps on with this kind of tutorials and live sessions wherein we can join together and learn new artworks. You can also share it with those who might be interested in art, learning art. So let all get benefited. And here I'm adding the anklet. This. Now the center portion is vacant, and I would add dhoti. Now since the dresses will have more borders, broader borders as compared to the jewelry. Jewelry is thin, but here we'll add more border for this place. I'm doing overlapping here, so you will see a little different kind of effect. It's very slight change, but it is more dense. Like this. Giving a bigger design here. There's a tutorial which was not done live actually. There was a video which was recorded on how to make different kinds of flowers. So if you feel that you're getting stuck with flowers and the leaf design, it will come very handy to you. And here I will give the a cloth. The lines here, just wiggly lines. Like so. So this is not very ornamental, and we will thanks, Neha. Thank you so much. Don't worry, Moshmi. Even if you are late, it will be posted and you can just have a look at it. This is what we did. All the proportions and everything is explained. So you can just start viewing it now. And then you will be able, after the session ends, you will be able to view all of it. So here the knee. And this is the... Now when we do the dress, I will just go ahead and make some print so that it falls as a dress. Now I'm just keeping it very simple. There are not many prints. We'll just do further more videos and then I will take different prints for different attires. So here, now since this is all left, I will be just giving it a nice bulge. So do not make it like a straight waist. It is like a muffin band kind of a thing, muffin flow. So this is kind of the... And a little detailing. So these cherries, this kind of a design, and I guess it's done. Now, once this all thing is done, we have to add the cloth. So for the cloth piece, just take now we don't have much space here, but still I'll just do it here. So it goes down here like this and it falls like so. create the border. Now here in the dress, I'll just add the second outline so that it stays a little separate from the body. You can add any kind of a design. Here I've added those crosses and anything. It can have a dot, it can have the leaf. You can have different kinds of leaves, that has been already told. You can just make your own variation on what you want to do. Like this. The other, I'm just putting it on this side so that with this it looks more full and more complete, more dressed. Like this. Now it's not that all the things will come over it. Some things are overlapping, some things are behind. This is one. Now, none of the gods and goddesses that we would see would be sitting on the floor, of course. So we will just add a little base on the bottom. You may use a scale if you're not very confident putting straight lines. I will just go ahead and add a chalky or so I just roughly take it like this and there I go. So. So this is a base. I will give it a little floral on this other side. I'll change the direction so that I can hold it better. Thank you so much. Like this, I'm making a curve. I'll just lower it down so that it gets easier because it's a very beautiful flowy design. And here, curve, and here. Like this, and so this is our picture. We can go more elaborate. There's no end to do more and more in a picture, of course. Like here, I have not done few things here, which you may add if your time will permit it. So the border, You may do a beautiful border on it. And then plus, you can go a little more elaborate. I'll just go one side and probably show you how well you can do that. Because the picture has turned out to be beautiful. And we could finish it in 1 hour actually. So that's cool. So I'm putting those curves and we can do more and more and fill up the whole thing. Here I'll just add a shank kind of a design. So it's like this. I'll just lower it down. Probably it's easier for you to just check on that. And it's out of focus. Out of focus. You may add any of the design that you wish to, not necessary that you will be adding this, anything. You can also mix and match, whatever your imaginations, your creativity, your color combinations, whichever way you want to create this, you can go ahead. Now there is one more thing, that the last thing that we would want to when will we color this? Akanksha, we won't be able to color this right away because we already I think I'm taking a little more time from you all. So if possible, the coloring, I'll just post it as a video and you can just refer to it. I will just keep yourself notified as if you press the bell icon. If I happen to put that, you will get the idea. Now, the whole picture is ready, but it looks a little incomplete to me for the halo or the aura that is there. So we can add, you may want to add, so please add. For making a circle, I would always advise you that you take the help of anything that is around. And do not just start with the pen. You've already done a lot of work, right? So let's go to this pencil first and make the circle. Just one line is, as a guideline, is good enough for you to start. So yes, it has come out nice. And just a double. And then do not stop here, because even after the ear, if the circle continues, you have to continue with the circle. So pretty much one line has gone wrong. Make a fine circle. And yeah, that's here, and I will start doing it now. So here I added this. Now we have to add a little more beauty to this. And I'm just doing the inner crease. If you want more reference lines for this, and you want this line to be in pencil, do it in pencil. And then if in case you feel that you can take help with a lid or any other tool, a protractor, a compass, anything, or any rounded object, you can take only the guideline, and this scallop design and this all will go freehand on that. This was the last thing that was left, and as I mentioned, it's going to be a 1 hour, but I'm taking a little more time from you all. But this is one thing which is very, very important. This scallop design is very important. These curves, they may be shallow, they may be deep, they may be not very perfect, but do not try to do any of the kalamkari without it. So this is a must design that will be there. So there, we are done, and you may want to color few lines. You may color few lines. If you want to color the whole of it, you may color the whole of it. So just these lines will be good enough. And I guess this is perfect. Not yet, actually. We'll erase all our lines, and then we will just see the final product, how it comes, because there are a lot of proportion lines, circles, and rough sketches. That is just, if you want to color your design, I would suggest you that you never start coloring before you erase your pencil lines, because if you color it over the pencil line, it will be permanent and it will always be visible. So just go very clear on clearing your picture first before you start inking it with the colors. I guess we are done. And how about this? So this is a beautiful, pretty piece, and yeah, even I'm having thoughts of painting it and keeping it in my Deepavali puja. And there it is. We can go ahead and do the next as Lakshmi, and then the whole set will be ready. So any doubts that anybody has on today's, you can please put it up right now. I will be available and answer. I'm reading the chats and I can answer all your queries right now. So any questions? And pretty bees, it came out very well. Nice. It's not giving the full view here. Lovely, isn't it? So and it's a 1 hour thing. Cool. We can all do it. Thank you, Chandrika. Thank you. Thank you. Any doubts that anybody has? Well, a few of you have queries on colors as well. Colors, we do it in acrylic. That now we are doing it in acrylic. But still, there is a difference in acrylic basic colors that you get in bottles, and also the colors which look very much like the original colors. How we do that is we will be mixing the medium tones or subtle down the brightness of the colors, and then it starts looking more authentic. Most of such kind of pickers, we have seen that only the background is colored in a bright color, probably maroon, because maroon is easily available now as well. And in those times also, maroon was available. They used to treat the cloth with turmeric and dye, and then the alum, the fitkiri, the alum that we say, it was it used to react on it and give a very bright maroon color. How to erase carbon lines if we are tracing from a print out? Okay, Usha, if you are tracing from a print out, I would suggest do not use a blue carbon at all, blue or black. Take a tone which is very, very subtle, which will blend if you want to color it. So a yellow or a brown is a good thing to take the tracing on. The transfer ink is not that high. If you are doing it on a black, and then you can use the yellow and the brown works for all. We also get white carbon. So blue carbon and black carbons, I suggest not to take for your drawing purposes. Even if you are doing fabric painting or anything, the blue carbon, even if you are painting, the other color mixes with it and it gets the blue shade. Which paper are you using, ma'am? I used a cartridge paper. So a cartridge paper, probably not a very thick one. But if you want to do the painting, I would suggest that you go for a 300 GSM. Acrylic sheet also is good. So anything above 200 to 300 GSM would be a good bet, because if you paint, then you will not have any curls. A very thin paper, no matter beautifully drawn, and we start the painting, it gives a slight curve. Ma'am, acrylic colors are very sticky. What to do? So depends on which one you are using, Sahaj. If you are using the bottled ones or the tube ones will get sticky. That means that they are been on the shelf for a long time and they are not fresh. You can only add water to it when you are doing it, and not too much, otherwise the polymers will break and the color will get transparent. So do not add too much of water, but still, if just adding a one drop water is not helping you to get the same opaque color, then it's time to change your paints. 0.5, I didn't understand what is that. 0.5, okay. Any questions? Which pen I've told, it's Uniball, or any of the drawing pens. You can use Micron, you can use any of the pens. How to remove the shine from acrylic? So acrylic is known for its polymers, and then this shine will be there. If in case you want, and when you are doing on the paper, you are taking the pictures and all, you have to set it in an angle where the shine is not there, but acrylic will give you shine. If in case you do not want the shine, then you can go for the poster colors, but you have to be very, very careful that it should not go on the black line that you have done, otherwise that will get a little hazy. Ma'am, what are chalk colors? Chalk colors we do not do in this. Chalk colors are available in the market for very dry, matte finish. We use chalk colors. They can also be made in the house by using talcum powder or white cement or and fevicol, the white glue, and water and paints. So chalk paints are easily, we can make it. Yes, of course, you can use poster colors if you are not using it on the fabric. On the fabric, you have to go for the acrylic paints. Acrylic paints, that too, the fabric colors. Acrylic paints are in two variants. So acrylic is just the polymer base. So the binder is there. But when we talk about the acrylic paints, this is the acrylic paint. So this is a fabric-free acrylic paint, whereas sometimes you get we also called it acrylic paint. It comes as fabric colors. So fabric colors, it's written over here. It's fabric colors. It's a set of 12. But later when you see, it is acrylic. So they are, the both of them are acrylic. So if somebody says I'm doing a fabric paint, it's fabric paint is also a part of the acrylic paint. But the polymers and the binder is a little strong in this. So if you are trying to do it on a fabric which you will be washing and using, then you can go for the fabric paint, because once it dries, it is not very tight and it's wearable. Whereas acrylic paints, if you have to do it on the paper, get it framed, or a panel which you will not wash, even a cloth, then this is. What about gouache? Gouache, don't use gouache. Here on the paper, you can use gouache. But on the paper, you can use gouache, poster, acrylic. Anything. Thank you, Surika. Thank you. So I will be ending the session today. If you have any queries, you write it in the comment box and give a like. Do not forget to share a like with me so that I get to know how much you all are participating and how much you are liking it, so that it gives me a lot of courage and inspiration to do more than what I am doing right now. So please hit on the like on the video, okay? And I will see you all next week at 3 o'clock again with beautiful postures and how to do full figures with proportions. So it's gonna make you easy. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. All the doubts please will be answered in the comment box. Now I will be ending the session and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you, everyone, and happy Raksha Bandhan to all of you.